Hey guys, what's up? Matt here once again. Today, bring you a brand new video on how exactly to take care of fresh new earlobe piercings. What is the proper aftercare method? Well, right now we're gonna dive into that and kind of go over all the basics on how to properly take care of your new earlobe piercings. So first off, the aftercare method that I'm about to recommend to you guys, I actually learned it from the Association of Professional Piercers, okay? They have a website, it's called safepiercing.org. You guys are totally more than welcome to check it out yourself. They have this all written down on their website. They're an association that basically all the professional piercers kind of look to for guidelines on proper piercing techniques, proper aftercare, proper jewelry, all that other stuff, okay? Definitely check them out. If anybody's telling you anything different than what I'm recommending to you right now, they're probably not going off of APP's guideline. Let's dive into this, okay? So how do you exactly take care of your earlobe piercings? Well, first off, most earlobe piercings are gonna take 2 to 3 months to heal. You don't touch them, you don't play with them, you don't spin or rotate them, like none of that stuff. It's not like when you get your earlobe pierce at the mall at a kiosk and they tell you to spin and rotate the jewelry. It's the exact opposite. You wanna leave them alone and let them be. That whole spinning the jewelry is just urban myth. Leave them alone. You have a scab in there, and when you're spinning and rotating, it's like picking out a scab, okay? So obviously, that's not a good thing. So 2 to 3 months is like your basic healing time, okay? So for 2 to 3 months, you don't wanna change, touch, or mess with your jewelry. Very important not to change your jewelry too soon, okay? I would say 2 months would be the ultimate soonest that you can actually change your jewelry, but just know when you do change your jewelry, as soon as you take something out, you immediately put something back in there, okay? That first year or more, it can still technically close up on you, so make sure you always kind of keep something in there. If you can go a solid 3 months or even longer without changing jewelry, that's ideal, but 2 months would be the bare minimum before you try to change your jewelry at all. Next up is never ever put hydrogen peroxide, alcohol, Neosporin, Bactine, none of that stuff on there, okay? It's way too harsh and actually it just does a lot more damage than good. If you read on, say, a tube of Neosporin, it says on there specifically, not for puncture wounds. This piercing is a puncture wound. Hydrogen peroxide, alcohol, those kind of products, they're just way too harsh and they just go in there and kill everything, good and bad. And they definitely kill a lot more good than they do bad. So avoid any of those products. So you might be wondering, exactly how do you clean your piercing if you can't use any of those products? Well, what we're gonna recommend to you right now is gonna be a saltwater spray, okay? Saltwater sprays are hands down, as of right now, the best product you could possibly use to clean a fresh new piercing. In the past, we've been recommending a lot of saltwater soaks. Saltwater soaks are still really, really good. We have past videos you can check out if you wanna learn how to do that. But honestly, it's a lot more work than it's probably worth. When the saltwater sprays are so simple and so convenient, you might as well just go ahead and go with the saltwater sprays. Now, when it comes to saltwater sprays, there's a few different products on the market that you can look into, okay? Right now, I have two of them right here. We have Neomed and we have H2 Ocean. Those are probably your two main brands right there. Both are really, really good products. I like Neomed a little bit better. I might be a little biased. I just like the fact that it's a straight, sterile, saline spray. Whereas H2 Ocean has a few other added ingredients. We did a video on H2 Ocean not too long ago. Still a great, great product. But if I was going between these two, I'd choose the Neomed over the H2 Ocean. Another product, if you don't have access to either one of these, which you should be able to find online really, really easy or any piercing shop, you can go to a pharmacy or a drugstore and there's also a saline wound wash. Okay, once again, it's just another straight saline sterile spray. That product works just as good also. So what you're gonna do with these products is you're gonna take them and spray them front and back morning and night, okay? You're not moving the jewelry, you're not kinda doing anything but spraying it down front and back morning and night. After you spray it down, you're gonna take a paper towel, and you're gonna fold it up and get that corner wet just a little bit, and you're gonna wipe around the jewelry to clean up any debris or buildup or anything like that. Just kinda get that all off of there, okay? Other than that, you just spray and leave it alone. Super simple, super easy, okay? In the shower, if you guys want, you can take a mild antibacterial soap and lightly wash the front and the back, and that also kind of helps to free up any buildup or dead skin cells or debris that might be building up on or around the jewelry. But you're trying to make sure, you're really, really trying hard not to get inside that hole, okay? You don't want that soap inside the hole, because once again, it just does a lot more damage than good. And another thing that's really important to try and avoid if you can, is try not to use any Q-tips or cotton balls. Q-tips and cotton balls, if you go and wipe down your piercings with them, it tends to leave little fibers behind, little cotton fibers that can cause irritations, infections, or just inflammation. That's why previously I said take a paper towel, fold it up, and get that corner wet and kind of wipe with that. Just because paper towels don't leave those cotton fibers behind. So definitely try and avoid the Q-tips and cotton balls if you can. All right, your primary source for cleaning these piercings is just gonna be your sterile saline spray, okay? So there it is, you guys. Super simple, super effective, and very, very easy, which means you're actually gonna probably do it. So pick up some of these saline sprays and spray your piercing down morning and night, and you should have no problems healing these piercings whatsoever. So once again, you guys, thanks again for tuning in, and we'll see you guys next video.